Ah, kids are everywhere. Some of them skated already. Some will skate between periods. Here at the Garden, it is Youth Hockey Night at MSG, and that is something special. These kids with dreams of meeting their favorite players, maybe becoming NHLers. Johan Holmquist started his NHL career with the New York Rangers. He has established himself as the number one goaltender for the Tampa Bay Lightning. And across the way, fellow Swede Henrik Lundqvist, ready to go. The entire Ranger team skated this morning. No optional. Tonight's high-definition broadcast is presented by Panasonic. It's time to bring back family time. Panasonic, ideas for life. Roosevelt and Malik on defense. Gomez, Jágr, and Hossa up front for the Rangers. And the referees tonight, Ian Walsh and Dan O'Halloran.
Now, Tom Rennie thought about, Sam, about putting a checking line together to play against the Le Cavalier line. He obviously has decided against it.
To start the game. Penalty upcoming. Gomez kept skating. Drew a penalty on the Lightning.
Yeah, he was. That's exactly what happened, Sam. He was skating and moving. He has decided, Tom Rennie has, to play the Gomez line, at least to start off, against the Le Cavalier line. Great puck movement by the Rangers to come out of their own zone, and then away goes Gomez. Just keeps skating. Paul Ranger was there. He gets the stick on him. Here he comes again. Rangers do a nice job getting out of their own zone with the puck movement. Gomez draws the penalty. Rangers get an early chance.
Ranger for hooking, and the puck is quickly cleared out by the Lightning. The bad news for the Rangers is they've scored power play goals in only three of the 10 games this season. Scored a total of seven power play goals, and just one for their last 17. Shanahan lost it. Former Ranger Jason Ward dropped it off. Brad Richards' shot is blocked. The Lightning, very dangerous team, shorthanded as well. Marty St. Louis, we showed you that graphic earlier with the shorthanded goals he scored in recent seasons. Rangers are offside. Brad Richards certainly dangerous shorthanded. New York Rangers hockey is brought to you by Budweiser, who thanks you for being a designated driver. John Tortorella, behind the bench of the Tampa Bay Lightning, took the team to the Stanley Cup Championship in 2004. A one-time Rangers assistant coach who's done an outstanding job with the Lightning.
He really has. He's a good coach, and he loves that up-tempo style of play. No sagging back and playing a slow-down game with John Tortorella. He wants his players to go. He wants them to come back hard and put back pressure on. He's plays an exciting style. He's a good coach.
Rangers on the power play have not gotten anything going as of yet. Brandon Dubinsky is on with Peter Pruka and Nigel Dawes, Paul Mara and Dan Girardi. Mara, one-time Tampa Bay Lightning. Here's Pruka. Looking, shooting, saved by Holmquist, no rebound.
Yeah, that's a perfect example of what the Rangers have been doing, and their coaches are trying to get them to not take so much time in taking the shot. Sometimes when you're pressing to score goals, you'll take a little bit more time and wait. Pruka, instead of shooting right away off the pass, takes his time. That allows the goaltender, Holmquist, to get over and get set. The coaches want him to shoot. Get the puck, shoot it right away, get people to the front of the net, get some traffic, look for some rebounds.
Face-off win. Roosevelt getting to the puck, giving it to Drury. They play the points with Jágr, Gomez, and Shanahan up front. Shanahan right at the top of the crease. Gomez pass deflected away, gets it back. Set up for Roosevelt, draws a man to him. That's Vinny LeCavalier, who knocked it away. Good play by Vinny LeCavalier.
You see that pressure? I mean, those forwards, those top two forwards for Tampa Bay, they just put pressure wherever the puck is.
Rangers back in with 25 seconds to go on the power play. Gomez on the puck. Now it's Jágr. Brad Richards back on with Jason Ward. Nice setup, save, Holmquist. Drury set up for a quick shot. That was good puck movement and a good save by Johan Holmquist.
Yeah, when you play against this team and they're so aggressive, you got to move the puck quickly because you're going to get pressure. There's the initial, the pass, and then the quick shot. You see the pressure, look at over on this side. That's Marty St. Louis with the pressure there. And then look at Le Cavalier come this way. Here comes the pressure there, and it eventually makes a good play to clear the zone.
Lightning have given up only one power play goal in the last five games. 13 for 14. Roosevelt shoots, glove save by Holmquist. A beauty with 3 seconds to go on the power play for the Rangers.
Yeah, that's what you like to see, Roosevelt take the shot. Roosevelt's got a good shot. And there it is, nice and low. That's a good save. Holmquist is off to a good start this season for Tampa Bay. Started the first 6 games of the regular season. And Roosevelt's got a good shot. Good job by Holmquist to not allow a rebound.
The other goaltender for Tampa Bay is Marc Denis, who has not played all that much. The Lightning coming in with a 5-3-1 mark. And Marc Denis has played only 2 games. This is Holmquist's 9th. Power play is over. Rangers getting 3 shots on goal on that man advantage. Another long shot knocked aside. St. Louis with a puck. As Al mentioned right at the top, the Lightning have not won on the road yet this season. They're 0-3.
And you know what, Sam? Last year, they were a good road team, and they weren't all that good at home. About 500 at home, but very good on the road.
Very strong thus far to start the season at home.
John Tortorella said one of the problems on the road has been they haven't gotten off to good starts. The beginning of games have not been good for their team on the road.
Rangers with Tootin and Girardi on defense. Brad Lukowich, who's back with Tampa Bay after being with New Jersey, signed a 3-year contract with the Lightning, and he's very, very happy to be back.
He sure is. Term of the contract was more important than the actual dollars, and they were able to get that done. He's getting a lot of ice time here in Atlanta, or pardon me,
said
here
he,
in Tampa Bay for
said
Tampa
Bay. He still
Bay.
Had the championship gear that he wore when he played with the Lightning the Stanley Cup year in 2004. Took it out of the drawer and put it on and celebrated signing a new deal.
He and his daughter.
Jágr working deep. It's given away to Lukowich. Swings it around the board, stopped by Roosevelt. And it's whistled down. The puck had come outside, just outside the zone, and was put back in offside against the Rangers. Well, fans, all season long, the Rangers, Islanders, and Devils battle for local supremacy in the Hummer Metro Ice Challenge. Tune to MSG this Saturday night when the Rangers take on the Devils in a head-to-head matchup. At 7 o'clock, the Hummer Metro Ice Challenge, a season-long competition to be determined between the games involving all 3 local teams. Behind the net is Matthew Darche, number 21 for Tampa Bay. At the point, Philippe Kuba swings it around. Shanahan, Mara chipping it off the boards. Shanahan reaches in. It's kept in by the one-time Pittsburgh Penguin, Michel Ouellette. Number 7. Ranger shot blocked. Good job by Mara. Mara played 3 seasons with the Tampa Bay Lightning. That shot was missed. Mark Stahl gave it away to Chris Gratton. Now it's Darche for Gratton. Good play by Stahl checking Gratton. Rangers can't get out. Gratton's open. He shoots, save with a left arm by Henrik Lundqvist. It was a nice pass from Ranger to Gratton, and Lundqvist with a tough save.
Well, you know what's happened with Tampa Bay in their second and third lines. They switched wings around about the fourth game into the season or fifth game into the season. They ended up putting the former Ranger, Jason Ward, up to the second line, and Ouellette, who's a goal scorer, they moved him down to the third line from the second line. And all of a sudden, things clicked. They've got a better, more balanced scoring attack now.
Now we have fourth line against fourth line. Rangers have Betts, Colton Orr, and Jason Strudwick on with Tootin and Girardi. Here's Strudwick against Mike Lundin. Lundin, young player out of Minnesota who played at the University of Maine. Girardi got knocked down by Andre Waugh. Andre Waugh, number 36, with Craig McDonald, number 29, and Nick Tarnaski, number 74. That's the Lightning's fourth line. Strudwick trying to set up Betts, and McDonald able to work it out. Betts takes it back, dumps it deep, and the Rangers get a line change.
Nice shift by that fourth line of the Rangers. A little bit of pressure, kept the play in the offensive zone.
Nice move by St. Louis. Then he fell down, able to dump it in. Roosevelt gets it to Gomez.
St. Louis was Jágr. He was looking for a tripping call against Hossa.
Jágr puts it in the corner. Marcel Hossa after it against Philippe Kuba. Now it's Jágr coming over. Once again, top line against top line here. Crossbow. Intercepted by Malik. Nearly 7 minutes into the game, no score. And the Lightning are offside. 13:04 to go, first period. No score in the game.
Here's a look at the Cannon goal cam. Number 77 is Chris Gratton of Tampa Bay. He'll try to make a play, keep it alive. Good play by Mark Stahl on him in front. But keep an eye on Chris Gratton over to the left. Oh, he ends up with it after the turnover by the Rangers. And good save by Henrik Lundqvist. And Andre Roy always finishes his checks. Big hit. And then this is the one that St. Louis wanted a call as Hossa got the stick in the skates. None was.
Improving digital imaging at work, home, or play. Canon Image Anywhere. The former MVP in the National Hockey League, Martin St. Louis. One-time Ranger Yanilovich back in the NHL after 3 years away. Well, the first year was the lockout year, and the last 2 years was away, playing in Europe. And welcome back to the NHL. Number 17, there he is, Yanilovich. The answer to our trivia quiz the other night.
You got that right.
I did. So did you.
Uh-huh.
Brad Richards along the boards, toward the net, knocked away. Yanilovich, we asked him, Joe and I were talking with him before the game, asked him who called whom. That shot saved by Holmquist, kept in. And he said perhaps the fact that he knew John Tortorella, and John, and they score! The long shot found a way in. One of those throw the puck to the net shots, and it's in.
Sam, it was deflected, I believe, about 20 feet out. I think Nigel Dawes gets the goal. This shot was going to go well wide. An initial chance here by Drury. And then as the puck stays in, Nigel Dawes on the other side, short side. There it is. I think Dawes tipped it in. Keep an eye on Dawes over here. Pardon me. That's a beautiful deflection by Dawes. Beautiful deflection. Watch him just with the soft hands. Look at the soft hands.
Oh, wow.
That's a beauty. Nigel Dawes scores again. And the Rangers off to a good start with a 1-0 lead.
Nigel Dawes with his third goal. And the Rangers score first.
He's got it going, doesn't he?
We mentioned it the other night. You can see him just play with much more confidence than before. Another shot by Gomez on goal.
And you know what? Give Paul Mara credit for that.
Yeah.
He had his head up all the way. He wasn't just getting the puck to the net, but he had his head up, and he saw Dawes over there, and that's where the puck was going.
Well, Lundqvist tried to bat it to the boards. Instead, he almost gave it away to the Cavalier. Sets up St. Louis, missed, and it's out of the zone. Here comes Gomez. 3-on-2 across the line. Gomez looking. Tried to put it in front. It was blocked with Hossa driving to the net. Shanahan will get one of the assists. And the other assist to Paul Mara. Brendan Shanahan, 1,298 career points.
That's it? Gotta get more than that.
That's all. Come on, Brendan, what are you doing?
He's off to a slow start.
Pick it up here. Third goal of the season for Nigel Dawes. Time of the goal, 7:40. That's Mike Lundin, number 39, against Truca along the boards. Up ahead to Gratton. Good pass through to Michel Ouellette. And now Matthew Darche plays it. Backhander goes through. Gratton knocked down in front. Good effort by Ouellette. Mark Stahl waits. Able to get it through to Pruka. Can't clear. Good job by Shane O'Brien on the original keep in. O'Brien, number 55, paired with Mike Lundin, number 39. The positive news, though we haven't seen him on the ice yet, is that Dan Boyle, outstanding defenseman for the Tampa Bay Lightning, who was injured in preseason, a weird
freak
accident. His skate fell off a hook and just cut his arm
right
badly.
Sam, cut him right down to the ball.
Tough bouncer. Shot by Kuba, redirected. That's a save. Good redirection by Andre Roy. And here's Nigel Dawes.
Dan Boyle will only play power plays tonight.
Dawes with a good hit on Brad Lukowich.
And they did not dress an extra defenseman. John Tortorella told us before the game.
Good save by Lundqvist on a tough shot.
He said they generally just play five defensemen during the course of a game anyway, so no need to dress an extra one. And they'll let Boyle play the power plays if they get one. They haven't had one yet. Under 10 minutes to go here in the first.
Roosevelt and Malik. Rangers a 1-0 lead. 9:25 to go in the first period. Roosevelt looks around. Richards pressures him. Betts moves it to Malik. Roosevelt was stopped. Good effort by Jason Ward. Jason Ward, who left the Rangers, went to L.A., things didn't work out there. He's very happy now in Tampa Bay.
Here's a look at the Panasonic digital replay. Look at this puck take a hard right as Lundqvist comes out to play. It almost misplays it. Puck bouncing a little bit. And there's the quickness of this Tampa Bay team. Oh, look at that short hop. Looked like your boy A-Rod there making that save, Sam. And then there's
Nigel
Dawes.
He's not my guy anymore.
He's not?
No. It's time to bring back family time. Panasonic ideas for life.
What happened?
Bye-bye.
Oh, boy.
Hey. I'm sorry. I didn't like that act.
See you later.
Thanks for the memories. Filip Kuba goes to get the puck. The Lightning starting out the stretch of games here in which they will play all three metropolitan area teams. Devils up
penalty
next
coming up here.
And first penalty to the Rangers.
Chris Drury.
Drury goes off. And a dangerous thing to give the Lightning the power play.
Now Colton Orr, last shift. He was involved in a play over at the boards and kind of an awkward. He was at an awkward angle and seemed to hurt his right arm.
Yeah.
And went immediately to the Ranger bench. And meanwhile, the penalty. There's St. Louis. He's low to the ground and gets taken down by the stick of Chris Drury. This is a dangerous power play.
Five to their last 16 over the last four games. Drury tripping at 11:16. Excuse me, 11:17, the time of the penalty. Rangers with a 1-0 lead. Good play by Girardi. Girardi and Tootin, and Tootin clears all the way down.
And Dan Boyle, as we talked about, he's number 22 in the white. It's his first shift of this season.
That's right.
And Sam, they miss him. Just one goal by their defense. Last year, he had 20 goals and 63 points.
And this is some power play unit. Le Cavalier, Saint-Louis, and Prospel up front. Richards with a drive and a save by Lundqvist, and he holds it. Richards and Boyle playing the points. Those are five outstanding offensive players.
Yeah, well, their options are many. Brad Richards, who has the puck now, he's a great passer. So the options are he's got St. Louis, will come over on this side, pardon me. And then over here, you've got Vinny LeCavalier. So his option is to take the shot because he's got St. Louis going to the net, or they'll dump it off to Vinny LeCavalier and let him shoot the puck, which he does well. And then on the other side, you've got Filip Kuba.
Betts won the faceoff. Rangers able to clear. 1:05 to go on the power play. Brad Richards playing in his 500th NHL game, carrying the puck. Saint Louis for LeCavalier, offside against the Tampa Bay Lightning. 1 minute remaining. There's Dan Boyle.
Yep.
Good to see him back. He's a good guy and a good player.
He is a real good player. You talk about someone that he used to be with Florida, and they got rid of him for a fifth or sixth round pick, I believe, at the time. And just, not a very big guy, and they believed in him in Tampa, and they gave him a chance. John Tortorella and that group, and he is a heck of a player.
You're right about that, Joe. I think in his days with Florida, he was a defensive liability. He was shaky in his own zone.
Yeah.
But Tampa worked with him, gave him the opportunity. The more he played, the better he got. It was as simple as that. They gave him ice time. They said, "You're our guy," and he's taken it from there.
He's really worked at his defensive side of the game. I mean, the guy's an all-star player now in the league, is what he is. not just because of his offense. He can kill penalties and play against top players.
Rangers able to clear. Good job on the penalty kill for the Rangers. They've got Dawes and Shanahan on there who now go off in favor of Yager and Gomez to finish up the penalty kill. Boyle takes it deep. It deflects behind the net. Dan Boyle sends it back to the point. Philippe Kubo with a shot. Deflected wide. Stahl drives it up the boards and out, and that will do it. Good penalty kill for the Rangers. Lightning had only one shot on goal. 6:40 to go. First period. Rangers with a 1-0 lead.
And Dan Boyle's first shift this year was 2 minutes.
Full power play. Well, he was well rested,
yeah,
Joe.
That's true. He's worked hard to get ready for this, so his conditioning not a problem. But they just want to make sure that he feels comfortable playing in all situations with that wrist. Sam, that cut him right down to the bone, that skate.
Just
severed three tendons.
That's scary.
Had surgery on September 23rd. I'm actually surprised he's back this soon.
It was after a preseason game, and he's in the locker room changing, and the skate falls down and lands on his wrist. Quick shot, save made by Lundqvist. A glove went flying.
Oh, that was a hit by Tootin.
That was Craig McDonald took the shot. His helmet went flying off. McDonald has gone to the bench. Girardi with the bump along the boards on Darsh. Now Tootin takes over against Matthew Darsh. Darsh staying with the puck, shielding it with the body. Tootin staying with him. Crowd alive after that hit. Shane O'Brien, one-time member of the Anaheim Ducks. Lundin's shot was tipped away by Tootin, trying to chip it off the board. Stopped by LeCavalier. Pass through, taken off the boards by Jason Ward. Ward against Girardi. Penalty upcoming on the Rangers. Good job by the Lightning. They kept the pressure on the Rangers, kept possession of the puck, and drew a penalty. Darsh throws it in front. Ward fanned on the shot. Rangers touch up, and finally the whistle stop play and the power play on a hooking call to the Rangers.
Here's a look at the Panasonic digital replay. The coaching staff has been trying to get their defensemen to separate the opposition from the puck. This time, it's a helmet, glove, stick, and everything that gets separated. What a hit by Tootin on McDonald, who was a little off balance at the time and looking at his shot. And he left shortly after that hit. And Tampa Bay just keeps it going. They show their quickness in the offensive zone, and Dan Girardi ends up with the hooking call.
It's time to bring back family time. Panasonic, ideas for life with the digital replay. Second power play for the Lightning. They came into the game tied for fifth in the NHL with the Philadelphia Flyers on the power play. 9-for-40 coming in, 0-for-1 in the game. Richards and Boyle play the points. LeCavalier, Prospel, and Saint-Louis up front. The pressure from Marcel Hossa. Hossa and Betts with Malik and Roosevelt, and Hossa with a good play.
Good work actually by both of those forwards, putting pressure first on LeCavalier, then on Richards, then forcing Boyle into a bad pass.
Boyle gains the zone. LeCavalier, not much room as Betts is on him. Boyle's pass tipped away by Hossa.
It's great work, isn't it, between the two of them? Individually putting pressure on, and then the second player just kind of reading off what the other one was doing.
Shanahan and Drury on now with Malik and Mara. Saint-Louis dropped it off to Prospel. Saint-Louis chases it down. Two men go to him. LeCavalier plays it back to Richards. Behind the back feed to LeCavalier. Checked by Drury. Put out in front. Prospel shoots. Saved by Lundqvist. Oh, Prospel had a little bit of an opening, and Lundqvist got there to make the save.
Yeah, the two Ranger forwards, Drury and Shanahan, try to do the same thing. There's Drury putting pressure on, but the quick puck movement by the Lightning, and Prospel off to that great start. There's the pressure we talked about. The two forwards, Hossa there helping out. Excellent penalty killing.
Lightning change units, bring on Gratton, Halavich, and Ouellette. Boyle stays on with Richards. Ouellette in the corner. Rangers have Marin Tootin on. Tootin tried to drive it around. Halavich blocked it. And that one is lifted clear. Good play once again by Marcel Hossa. Hossa and Betts working very well together.
And a quick shift, Sam. They're out there for about 20 seconds or so, and a quick change to stay fresh, get fresh people on the ice.
Right now, Rangers going with two pairs of penalty-killing forwards. The puck chipped up into the crowd, and play stops. Well, you can win a once-in-a-lifetime trip to Toronto to see Mark Messier's induction into the Hockey Hall of Fame. Rangers and Leafs game Saturday night, the induction on Monday night, and a whole lot more. Listen to Mike and Mike tomorrow morning on ESPN 1050 Radio for your chance to win. The blue shirt legend clue you'll need to win is Ed Jockeman. That's the clue, Ed Jockeman.
Okay. Listen, what time Mike can we call in?
From 7 to 8. Okay. You can't call in, I'm sorry.
No?
No. Sorry. Not allowed. Lightning now have 11 shots on goal. Long shot from the point blocked in front. They have 10 of the last 12 shots on goal in the game. 15 seconds to go on the penalty to Dan Girardi. 3:10 to go in the first period. Rangers keeping the puck away, and it's cleared all the way down by Tootin. Once again, a good penalty kill. At one point, the shots were 4-1 Rangers. Now 11-6 Tampa Bay. Rangers penalty kill 2-for-2, and they've given up only two shots on goal while shorthanded. Jágr, a nice move out of the zone. Beats Gomez. Back to Jágr. That was a pass for Gomez, who tipped it and got knocked down by Paul Ranger. Jágr spinning against Le Cavalier. Jágr takes a hit from Prospel. Gomez against Ranger. Double team by Prospel. Jágr digs it loose. Good play. Shot by Dawes. Save made by Holmquist. Puck is loose. Lightning find it. And Malik able to keep it in. Pass down low, intercepted and cleared. And then Malik knocks it down. Malik for Jágr. Rangers offside.
Boy, that's good work.
To go.
That's great work. Down underneath the goal line, both by Jágr and by Gomez. And while all this is going on, reading the play is that man right there, Nigel Dawes, who just waited. Jágr found him, and Dawes almost got another one. There it is in the crease, and then Holmquist gets some help from his defenseman Ranger.
Stahl pressured by Jason Ward, reversed it. Mara goes up ahead to Hallway. Pass tipped by Ward. And here's Dubinsky with Pruka. And the Rangers offside again. Word from the Tampa Bay locker rooms that Craig McDonald's lip is being stitched up after that hit. Rangers had brought in Dave Scatcherd, a veteran forward, for a tryout. He was sent to Hartford, and now he has been released. So no signing of Dave Scatcherd. Good guy. Hadn't really had a training camp and wasn't in top shape. Hurt himself with a groin injury in his second game with the Wolfpack, and never really able to get to the top of his game. So he's been released.
Yeah, the other thing that would have had to have happened is they would have had to think that maybe Dubinsky couldn't do the job. And so they started giving Dubinsky a little bit more ice time at the time that Dave Scatcherd was getting the tryout to see if Dubinsky could handle it. Dubinsky actually got better. So that certainly played into the decision.
Rangers, good work along the boards. Long shot by Stahl, stick save by Holmquist. I think the other thing too, Joe, is that Greg Moore is playing very well for the Wolfpack right now. He's both a center and a winger, right now playing more center, and has done a good job.
Yes.
And he's got the potential to be called up somewhere down the line. Icing on Tampa Bay, 1:09 to go in the first period. Rangers with a goal by Nigel Dawes, a deflection. Redirection. A shot that was going wide. And this happened earlier. Gomez driving to the net against Paul Ranger.
And then Ranger gets him in the face with the glove. That line's been pretty good.
Face-off win by Drury. Girardi shot blocked. And it comes to the line, kept in by Tootin. Drury takes a hit. Shanahan shot knocked away with a blocker by Holmquist. Under a minute to go in the first period. Rangers a 1-0 lead. Dawes done a good job playing the body. Long shot glove by Holmquist. Girardi taking the shot. Good job by the Rangers on that shift. Working the boards well.
Yeah, both Shanahan in the corner a couple of times. Nigel Dawes on the boards about halfway up to the blue line. Both players working well. That's Dawes first. That gets it in deep. Then Shanahan. Here's Dawes again over on this side. Keeps the play alive. Shanahan down here. Keeps the play alive. Eventually, they'll get the shot from the point. That's good work.
Rangers, Gomez in the corner. Tried to set up Jágr. The pass was tipped. Malik with a shot. Save, Holmquist. Hossa. Gomez throws it into the corner. Milavich there to get it. Lifts it on the backhand.
This line's been good. Every time they're on the ice, something seems to be happening.
Halavich tipped it away from Jágr. Malik is there to play it. Halavich after him. Halavich always a good skater. Played with Vancouver and Carolina after playing with the Rangers.
Yeah, he's getting about 16 minutes a game, which he says is perfect for him.
Final seconds of the period, and the Rangers will walk off the ice. Skate off the ice, actually, with a 1-0 lead, and that's good news.
That's good news, and now they need to try and build on that. Nigel Dawes continues to play great hockey for the Rangers. Every game, he's very noticeable on the ice, making plays, getting shots, and the goal he scored tonight was just a beautiful redirection of a perfect hard pass, half shot by Paul Mara.
First Ranger to score 3 goals this season. It hasn't been a good offensive year thus far. Al's downstairs with Perry Pern. Go ahead, Al.
Coach, what's your take on the first period?
Well, a good start for us. I think, you know, getting the first goal is always important. I think handled a couple of power plays from them. They're a very good power play team. So I think a lot of things done very well that period.
Great period for Nigel Dawes, don't you think?
Nigel Dawes has been playing well for a while, not just the first period tonight.
He's your leading scorer. Surprise. Sam, back to you.
Thanks, Al. This is the Mercedes Intermission Report. And coming up, Al will be in the studio with Ryan Holwig. Tonight is youth hockey night. And we'll talk about Ryan as a youth. and Drury. Jágr with room. Heads for the net and shoots. Glove saved by Holmquist.
Well, his glove has been good. Jágr made a very good play right at his own blue line. He knocked the attempted clearing attempt by the Lightning, knocks it down there with his glove, and then just darts into the middle, sees all those players in front. Drury was there looking for a deflection, but the glove hand of Holmquist has been very good. It's been really good in this game.
Along the boards, Gomez gets it back to Jágr. 20 seconds in the 5-on-3, Roosevelt to Jágr. Roosevelt looking. Shanahan checked by Kuba. Kuba, Ranger, and Richards on for Tampa Bay. 8 seconds in the two-man pass to Gomez, saved by Holmquist. He robbed him again.
Yeah, Shanahan with a beautiful pass. Beautiful pass from the other side. And Gomez didn't waste any time. The quick pass all the way across. And Holmquist had looked like he had his right skate on one post and his left skate on the other post. Look at it.
Yep.
There they are, both skates on the posts, and took everything away down low. You know, Gomez is another player that before every game day practice in the morning gets out and spends a lot of time taking shots.
Big face-off, 5 seconds in the two-man advantage. Roosevelt looking, shooting, saved by Holmquist, no rebound. And LeCavalier's out of the penalty box. 1:02 to go in the Rangers' power play. It's still 1-1, and now it's a 5-on-4 skating advantage.
And then Jágr and Roosevelt having a conversation as the two of them head to the bench.
Dubinsky against LeCavalier. Paul Ranger comes around the net with it and fires it down the ice.
Big faceoff win by LeCavalier.
4.5 minutes to go, second period. Game tied 1-1. Nigel Dawes scoring for the Rangers in the first. Vinny LeCavalier penalty shot here in the second. Mara shoots high, deflected off the glass. Pruka working against San Luis. It's taken away by Kuba. Diving effort by Girardi, just couldn't keep it in. Dawes stopped by Kuba. San Luis looks around. LeCavalier's with him. And he sends it back to kill time. Smart play by Marty San Luis. 10 seconds to go on the Ranger power play. Girardi outlets to Gomez. Gomez with Dawes. Back for Gomez. Power play is over. 4 shots on goal for the Rangers. Jágr. But the Rangers fail to capitalize on a two-man advantage. Jágr's shot blocked into the corner by Jason Ward. The former Ranger sends it around the boards. Craig McDonald couldn't move it out. Shane O'Brien lost it to Jágr. Gomez around the net against Ward. Now it's Jágr. Checked by Lukowicz, who knocked him down. And a good play by the Lightning, keeping the Rangers to the outside and finally taking the puck away. 3 minutes to go in the second. Tied 1-1. Rangers with a 56-second two-man advantage and fail to convert. Strong goaltending by Johan Holmquist. Back for the puck, Paul Mara. Puck was knocked down by Paul Ranger. Sent the other way by Mara.
John Tortorella telling us before the game, he says, I know the Rangers are going to break out of this thing. He said they have to. He said, I'm hoping and praying that it's not tonight.
Mike Lundin plays it off the boards. Stahl looks around. Takes a hit from Matthew Darche. And offside whistled against the Lightning with 2:17 to go in the second period. Tied at 1.
Youth Hockey Night at Madison Square Garden. There are the Bronxville Mites. The team is here from Greenwich, Connecticut. and also here the Putnam Hockey Association. And I'd like to introduce you to two longtime Ranger equipment assistants, Joe Davini, who's been helping the Rangers out for 35 years, his son Scott. Every year in the Putnam Association, they play for the Sandy Davini Cup. Joe's wife and Scott's mom passed away in 1991. It's a great tradition. She was a great soccer mom. She had to be for you to get through it and play hockey, right?
Yeah, you know, it's a lot of cold mornings up there at those rinks, you know, and she always had the hot chocolate and the gloves, always had a smile on her face no matter what time it was, and just always support for, you know, everyone that was up there. She was like a surrogate mom to a lot of kids up there, so.
It's a great thing that you guys were able to keep her memory alive. Joe, congratulations for supporting Putnam Hockey for 35 years.
Thank you, Al.
Sam, back to you. A really nice story.
It absolutely is, Al, and
it's a good
always
family,
great to
isn't
see
it?
Joe yeah. and Scott and the... The men behind the scenes here at the Garden who make it all work.
Good people, just great people. Care an awful lot, passionate about what they do, passionate about the game.
That's right. I've seen a lot of players come through. Oh, they love their hockey. Puck coming out, Marty St. Louis. Intercepted, Roosevelt. Jágr, shoot, save, Holmquist. Now there's the case, there's Roosevelt, dead center. He went to the angle to Jágr, not as good a shot as Roosevelt might have had, in my opinion.
No, well, he tends to, you know, tends to dish off to 68 when he can. And that's the thing about Roosevelt that sometimes can be frustrating because he does have a very, very good shot.
Drury wins the faceoff, but out of the zone it goes. Girardi able to chase down. Minute 40 to go in the second, tied 1-1. Rangers now out shooting the Lightning, 11-6 here in the second. For the game, 21-17. Backhander by Halavich off the chest of Lundqvist. Halavich has it back, but gave it away. Drury couldn't get it by Halavich, who took it back. Girardi. Good play under pressure by Dan Girardi.
He makes those plays look easy, doesn't he? He gets all that pressure and he's cool, he's calm, and makes a nice little soft pass.
Richards was stopped. Combination of Drury and Holwig. Holwig moves in. Holwig drives to the net. Saved by Holmquist. Oh, strong move by Ryan Holwig.
Holwig knew he had a step and just turned it on, used his left arm, his left shoulder, and his left leg to protect the puck. What? Now he knows he's got a lane. Now he protects it, and Holmquist has played a very solid game. He's been helped out by the Rangers hitting three posts in this game, but that being said, Holmquist has played well. Positioning has been good. His glove hand has been excellent.
Well, he's been very solid. Since the championship year in 2004, there's been a question about the goaltending for the Lightning. They had Nick Haabibulin win them the Stanley Cup, or help them win the Stanley Cup. But now it looks like Johan Holmquist is the definite number one. Fans, last-minute individual Rangers game tickets are available on NewYorkRangers.com or via MSGTicketExchange.com. So, at the last minute, if you're looking for tickets to the game, those are the websites to check out. Jágr trying to cut in front and got hit by Shane O'Brien. The net was lifted up off the pegs, almost fell on top of Jágr and Holmquist.
And Jágr, using his size and his strength, look at him just keep going. That's what makes him, he's so difficult to stop. You get him one-on-one, and 250 pounds of him going to the net makes it difficult to try and slow him down.
21.5 seconds remaining in the period. Filip Kuba. Mara there to play it. St. Louis was still in the zone, has to touch up and get onside. Final seconds of the second period. The goals continue to be tough to come by for the Rangers. They didn't give up much, but Marek Milik with a hook on Vinny LeCavalier resulted in a penalty shot, and LeCavalier with a classic move, just a beautiful backhander, couple of fakes. Now here's the rule: if the foul was from behind and a more reasonable scoring chance was denied due to the foul, then a penalty shot should be awarded, and that was exactly the case.
Yeah, he didn't, as it turned out, he really didn't get a shot. He's in the clear, tries to protect the puck. There's no question Malik was from behind, got the stick out on the arms. It wasn't much, but it was enough to prevent a good scoring chance.
And we had two special guests with us today, Michael Docherty and Mark Mullitz from Selden, New York. They won a VIP package, including a visit to the booth at the New York Rangers Casino Night fundraiser to benefit the Garden of Dreams Foundation. They had lunch with Adam Graves. They went to practice this morning. They had dinner here tonight. They're having a great time. We're having a great time, too. We'll be right back.
And here in on Henrik Lundqvist, you know he's proud of this, the way he handled shootouts and penalty shots, but that one got between the legs, and that is where we stand. So here are the Rangers, 20 minutes in a tie game. They've got to be the one to score the next goal.
And they have played the better of the first 40 minutes. They don't have the lead to show for it, but I think if they, as Brendan Shanahan would say, stay the course, I think they'll be okay, because I do believe they've gotten more quality scoring opportunities than Tampa has, and I think that will continue in the third.
They've been the better team tonight.
I think they have, but again, unless they win this game, they're not going to feel that way at all.
That's going to do it on the Mercedes-Benz Intermission Report. I do believe we have trivia in our future.
We are back at Madison Square Garden, the world's most famous arena for New York Rangers hockey, brought to you in part by Canon, improving digital imaging. At work, home, or play, Canon, image anywhere. And by New York Lottery. What a day for a daydream. I think I should sing that, Joe. Play New York Mega Millions. Hey, you never know. What a day for a daydream. It's trivia time.
Can we not have singing, please?
I agree with you. I'm with you, Al.
You didn't like that, what a day for a
daydream? I liked it.
All right. Thank you, John. Trivia quiz. Photograph of a current Ranger as a child. Who is he? Dan Girardi, 28%. Brendan Shanahan, 55%. Jason Strudwick, 17%. I'm going with Brendan Shanahan.
Me too.
Me three.
Me four. Look at the skates. There's no way Dan Girardi would use skates without the tuck, and there's no tuck on those blades.
And that's, yes, that's a pretty old picture, I think. Yeah.
We
and,
win.
And you can't put Jason Strudwick in there. He's a left-hand shot.
Well done, Al.
There's no digital in that picture. I guarantee you that.
Brendan Shanahan as a youth. A young youth. He's now a bigger youth. There we go. The Gia Wigs hanging in there. The fans with four. And Joe with the lead.
We're on a roll, Al.
Feeling good, Sammy.
That is genetic misfortune right there.
For who?
Both of us.
All right, we've been talking about youth hockey, and there's nobody better than working with youngsters than Adam Graves, who was on the ice with the youngsters earlier tonight.
Kids can get involved with your youth hockey clinics.
On the internet, just get on NewYorkRangers.com and click onto the kids program, the All-Star Club. And certainly this is what it's all about. It's all about the kids. And you'll see as they get out in the ice here, smiles on their faces. We have the Biondi brothers from Yonkers here running it. And they always help us when we have the clinics up at the practice facility.
What's the first thing we're going to see from the kids right now?
They're going to do the crossovers through the tops of the circles, bottoms, all the way down the ice. And again, the clinics are about working on skills, but equally, if not more importantly, about having some fun and taking the things that this great game of hockey teach us.
All right, let's have the kids start on our first drill.
These kids are from Bronxville and Greenwich, and tonight we have 800 members of through the tri-state area of minor hockey.
Now this is one of the drills all the kids really like, the Superman drill.
Well, again, this, you don't do this in hockey, but certainly this is one of their favorite drills, where they skate to center. They have to leave their feet at center and slide as far as they can and yell Superman at the same time. Again, it's all about having fun.
And here they go for the Superman drill. And at the red line. And let's see who gets the furthest. All right, pretty good slide, but you know, if the ice was fresh, they would have gone a little further.
You have to do that drill right after the Zamboni.
I remember you doing that to block shots.
Or to draw a penalty. That's before they used to call diving.
I love seeing Adam Graves work with the kids. I love to see him back here at Madison Square Garden. There's no greater ambassador for the game, and as I said before, nobody better to work with the kids than Adam Graves. Youth Hockey Night at the Garden.
He and Paul Maurice, the Toronto coach, have become very, very good friends. They live in the same area. Their kids are friends up in Toronto.
Oh, that friendship started a long, long time ago. Underway third period. What will give for the Rangers? They've scored only one. Nigel Dawes on a redirection in the first period. The Lightning looking for their first road win of the season. Their goal coming on the Vinny LeCavalier penalty shot in the second period. Malik Roosevelt, Yager Gomez, and Hossa for the Rangers. Misconnection on the pass turns into an icing against the Rangers. Paul Ranger, who has become a very important part of the Tampa Bay Lightning defense. Fans all season long, the Rangers, Islanders, and Devils battle for local supremacy in the Hummer Metro Ice Challenge. Tune to MSG this Saturday night. Rangers play the Devils, part of that Metro Ice Challenge. Game time, 7 o'clock. The Hummer Metro Ice Challenge season-long competition that'll be determined between the games involving the three local teams.
And Tampa Bay gets a fresh line on the ice because of the Rangers icing call.
Yager trying to move the puck out. It gets out of the zone. Gomez has changed for Drury. The puck comes in front, cleared aside by Malik. Brad Richards working along the boards. Hossa and Yager have had extended shifts here. That's played toward the net and gloved by Lundqvist to get a faceoff, and the Rangers will be able to complete the change. Mike Lundin, the youngster from Minnesota, just outside of Minneapolis, 23 years old from Burnsville, Minnesota, third-round draft pick in 2004.
He's been a big surprise for this Tampa Bay team. Of course, with Dan Boyle getting hurt, they needed some other defense to step up, and he has been one that has stepped up. He gets plenty of minutes. John Tortorella telling us how smart a defenseman he is. You watch him. He's just one of those. He's got good presence on the ice, knows where to be at all times, and has really been a surprise.
Played four seasons at the University of Maine.
Only missed two games in his four-year career at Maine.
Chipped into the Rangers zone. Girardi with Michel Ouellette on him. Ouellette, who played for the Pittsburgh Penguins, coming over to the Lightning this season. In the offseason, I should say. Round the boards to Drury. Drury with Dawes and Shanahan. Good pass from Dawes. Shanahan against Paul Ranger. Puts it in front. It's cleared aside. Nice play by the veteran Brad Lukowich. That shot by Darsh, deflected by Stahl, going up way up into the netting. And play stops.
Yeah, Brendan Shanahan, after taking a beautiful pass right there. Great pass. And Shanahan just tries to lower the shoulder and go to the outside. Paul Ranger did a nice job defensively against Shanahan, who went into the boards heavily. And then, you know, he's feeling his jaw. It looked to me like after he went into the boards that the skate of Ranger might have caught him in the face.
O'Brien against Gomez. Nice play by Gomez. Got good leverage. Here's the backhander by Yager that gets blocked. Another shot goes wide. Yager against Vinny Prospel. Knocked away from him. And Le Cavalier with Saint-Louis. Mara's back. Saint-Louis against Mara. Puck still alive. Gomez poking at it. Mara pinning Saint-Louis. Gomez against Prospel. And a good job by Prospel. Saint-Louis out to the point. O'Brien with a shot that deflects wide of the net. Gomez against Le Cavalier. Saint-Louis takes a bump. A wrist shot knocked down in front by Paul Mara. Pressure here from the top line of the Lightning, and Jose able to work it out.
Now, that's been the matchup, top line against top line throughout this game.
That's played toward the net, gloved by Lundqvist, leaves it for Mark Stahl.
And I would say, Sam, that the Gomez line has had the better of the opportunities.
Ooh, nice play by Jason Ward, took it away from Pruka. And then a real good play by Mark Stahl. Mark Stahl has fit in very, very nicely in his first year in the National Hockey League. Stepping up from junior hockey, he has looked totally in place.
And
this
getting
is where
better.
He belongs.
And getting better. He's a very quick learner.
Richards puts it in the Rangers zone. Roosevelt taking it away from Janulovic. Around the boards. Kept in by Lundin. Halavic shoved to the boards by Holweg. Brad Richards back to Janulovic. Halavic working the corner. Nice takeaway by Roosevelt. Played all the way through and taken off the boards by Peter Pruka. Puts it in the Lightning zone and chases against Lundin. Good effort by Pruka. Rangers finished in line change. Strudwick gets it back to the point. Shot by Tootin, blocked in front. Ball Ranger moves it. Knocked down by Richards. Long shift for Brad Richards. Strudwick on the forecheck. 4:40 gone by. Third period. Tied 1-1. The outlet to Andre Roy. Rangers take it back. Tootin against Roy. Girardi bangs it off the glass. Lundin and Strudwick. McDonald swings it around the boards, but Paul Mara is there. Stopped by Roy, and it deflects out to center. That time, the Rangers' fourth line able to keep the puck in the Lightning zone for most of the shift.
Both teams doing a pretty good job at playing defensive hockey, coming back, blocking passes and shots.
Yep. And taken deep by Saint-Louis against Mark Stahl. Set up for Le Cavalier. Stick save made by Lundqvist. Off the boards. Missed by Filip Kuba. It rolls all the way back. They're calling it an icing. I thought Kuba could have played that puck. Tried to play the puck. They whistle the Rangers for an icing.
Sam, you know, we talk about Adam Graves and everything he does outside of the game of hockey. Vinny Le Cavalier deserves some credit for something he just did. He's got a foundation called the VL4 Foundation, and just recently they donated $3 million to build a new hospital wing for children in St. Petersburg, Florida, and they're going to name this wing after Vinny Le Cavalier. They'll call it the Vincent Le Cavalier Pediatric Cancer and Blood Disorders Center. So he's done a lot of work with the hospital there, and it's a nice thing that he's helped raise all that money for that cause.
Well done by Vinny Le Cavalier right here. Paul Mara's going off for hooking Vinny Prospel, and the Lightning will get a power play here in the third period.
Now off the faceoff, Le Cavalier is taking the faceoff. The Rangers win the draw, and Mara has it, tries to move it, but see how quickly Prospel is in on top of him. And right away, Prospel gets the stick right in the passing lane, blocks the pass, and then draws the penalty.
Power play for Tampa Bay, their third of the game. They're 0 for 2. Takeaway by Betts. Breaking in on Holmquist. Chased by Richards, who broke it up. Great play by Brad Richards coming back. One thing that John Tortorella has never been afraid of is to play Richards at the point, because he has great defensive abilities. A great all-around two-way player. Le Cavalier against Hossa. Aggressive play by Marcel Hossa. And the Rangers take it away and clear. Hossa with a good job along the boards.
And a penalty coming up against the Lightning, I believe, Sam. And so it'll be a holding call. As Hossa was being held along the board, so we'll play 4-on-4 for the next 1:22. And then the Rangers will have a power play. There's Le Cavalier and Hossa battling it out. Prospel coming over to try and help out.
They called Le Cavalier for a hold on Hossa.
And then there's Richards trying to make the pass, and here comes Betts. And Richards, what a play. What a great defensive play by Richards coming back. Hard to believe he's a -5 this season,
that
Richards, with his ability. There it is again. Betts with the opportunity, and Richards with just a marvelous play.
New York Rangers hockey is being brought to you by Budweiser, who thanks you for being a designated driver. Le Cavalier for holding at 6:25. Teams are skating 4-a-side in a 1-1 game. The Rangers ultimately will wind up with a power play for 38 seconds. San Luis fans roar on a hit by Girardi. Shot by San Luis, a save by Lundqvist. Girardi with a big hit on Brad Richards. We step out with 13:08 to go in the third. That is Jim Gregory, one of the senior executives of the National Hockey League, with Charlie Joyce, longtime off-ice official, being awarded for 25 years of service to hockey. Congratulations to Charlie, and for Jim Gregory, in 2 weeks, he will be inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame. Congratulations to him.
Absolutely.
That's an honor, well-deserved.
Well, we're seeing Dan Boyle on the ice. It's not a power play. John Tortorella said, well, it's 4-on-4.
Well,
close enough.
Dan, can you give us some time, even strength?
He's got the puck now, and he's dangerous. He said the easiest thing to do with that wrist is to shoot a slap shot.
Hossa, Betts, Roosevelt, and Malik for the Rangers. Halavich with a puck here. Gloved wide of the net by Lundqvist, who drops it off to Hossa. Game tied 1-1. Rangers go on a power play in 30 seconds. Sent in the corner off the boards by Boyle. Malik controlling. Rangers finish a change. Jágr comes on with Gomez. Rangers on the power play in 10 seconds. Gomez, the trailer, Tootin, takes it deep. The back-end try was blocked.
That was Richards. Good defensive play with the stick.
Gomez broke his stick on the shot, and it bounced wide. Rangers on a power play, a short one. 30 seconds remaining in the man advantage. Drury has come on. Tootin able to work it to Drury. The back pass is tipped and out of the zone. Gomez back for it. Richards after him. Girardi with a puck. 15 seconds in the Rangers power play. Their fourth of the game. They're 0 for 3. Shane O'Brien in the corner. Kuba moved it. Gomez plays it back. Mara. Wrist shot deflected. And it goes in, but no goal. No goal. That went off the arm of Chris Drury, who had raised his glove and his hand to knock the puck down, and it went in off the glove.
It's the craziest thing going on, isn't it? This shot was deflected, and then Drury, all he tried to do, he just wanted to knock it down so he could play it with his stick, and it goes in the net, and of course it doesn't count. Of course. Of course it doesn't count. Huh?
They got to find a way to get the puck in the net.
Oh, boy.
There's that
just
Tootin
prior to
play.
That, yeah, that's the play. Richards came back with the stick, made a good play on Tootin. And then, you know, let's break a stick. I mean, it's just, it's crazy. What's going on, isn't it? It really is. They've hit three posts tonight. Knocked one in that doesn't count with a glove.
Well, they found a way to get it in the net.
Oh, man.
Cassio Marks, the Rangers lead equipment trainer, working on the visor of Chris Drury. Teams are back at full strength. 11:25 to go in this third period, tied 1-1. San Luis against Mara. Mara does a good job. Colton Orr tried to move it. It's blocked. Dangerous matchup here. Top line for Tampa Bay. Rangers fourth line. Betts, Holwig, and Orr on for the Rangers. Maron Staal, and the Rangers come out. Good job. And it's turned over in the neutral zone. But Colton Orr would stop Vinny Prospel.
Yeah, but Colton Orr made a good play. He was going to change. Then when he saw the turnover, he went right to the puck carrier right away and made the defensive play. And now that allows the Rangers to change everyone.
Puck over skated by Matthew Darche. Long shot by Ouellette goes wide. Looked like Lundqvist wanted to give it a header.
Yeah, I don't know if he got a piece of it or not. He had to readjust his mask after the attempt.
He loves that move, the header, the soccer-style save with a mask. Pass for Jágr, and a good check by Paul Ranger. Ranger stays with Jágr. Chris Gratton takes the puck away. Jágr takes it back, but he gave it away to Gratton. Ouellette, too far for Gratton. Roosevelt taken down. Gratton ties him up. Darche. And out with the puck is Peter Pruka. Ryan Holway goes wide against Lundin. Saved by Holmquist. Ouellette trying to clear it out. It was kept in by Tootin.
All right, not many shots here in the third period. Neither team giving up much defensively.
Pruka against Shane O'Brien. O'Brien stays with him. Pruka gets loose and then lost control of the puck. Dubinsky stuff in his stop. The net gets knocked off and the whistle stops play. 9:28 to go in the third. Rangers coming close, but Dubinsky was stopped.
Yeah, the Rangers will end up with a power play. Dubinsky, strong move here to get to the front of the net. And then look at Peter Pruka in front. And that's Chris Gratton from behind that gives him a little cross check. Meanwhile, there was Jágr getting hit earlier in the game. And that's the result.
The result is go to the dentist tomorrow.
Yes.
And this was Lundqvist trying the header, Joe.
Did he get it? I don't know.
I'm not sure.
Good try.
Let's see.
He might have got a piece of it because he had to make a little bit of an adjustment.
But here's a power play for the Rangers. Fifth of the game, 0 for 4. Jágr minus teeth is on the ice. Roosevelt with a good shot, stopped by Holmquist. Gratton for cross-checking at 10:32. Roosevelt across. Jágr shoots. He scores! Jaromír Jágr! It's a power play goal! And the Rangers lead it 2-1. Just what the doctor ordered.
Sam, they win the faceoff and they attempt two shots. The first one by Roosevelt, good save. It gets back to Roosevelt, pass, shot. Isn't that simple? In the net. Win the faceoff and they took two shots. That one might have been deflected a little bit on the way in.
Did it go off?
Possibly by the Tampa Bay player. The shot was low. It might have changed direction a little bit. But you know what? Take the shot. The Rangers do it. They've got a lead.
I wonder if it went off Shanahan's skate. Let's go down to the ice to Al Trotwig.
Sam, I don't think so. But after the goal was scored, Shanahan skated right in front of us here. And he had a smile on his face. And it wasn't a smile like, you know, I'm thrilled that we scored a goal. It was a smile that said to me, see, that's how you do it.
Yeah, and guess what, Al? He's right. Win the face, take the shots, make the pass, take the shots. If he didn't touch it, which I don't think he did, he certainly helped with the screen being in front.
Well,
I mean, do you see how simple that was? They win the faceoff, one pass, shot by Roosevelt. Get the rebound, back to Roosevelt, one pass, shot by Jágr. But I think it hit the Tampa player in front.
It was reviewed, and it counts as a goal. The Rangers, only the fourth game in which they've scored a power play goal this season. And the Rangers have the lead for the second time in the game. It's 2-1. Jágr gets his third of the season, now has a goal in each of the last two games. Prospel knocked down by Colton Orr, 8:45 to go, third period. Now, how will the Rangers play this? Will they play protect the lead and go into a defensive mode, or will they press and go for that third goal, which might be the put-away goal?
I think you got to play a combination. I mean, defensively, that's, again, we've talked about, it's the one area they've been pretty strong most of the season. But when you get a chance to put some pressure on and keep the puck in the other zone, you do that also.
Jágr from Roosevelt and Drury. Tootin shoots and it's blocked across. Halavich looking for Richards. Good play by Drury coming back. Jágr with his third of the season from Roosevelt and Drury at 10:45, a power play goal, giving the Rangers a 2-1 lead. Ward sends it in. Halavich puts it in the corner. Jason Ward there for Tampa Bay. Sammy Gomez moves it for Jágr.
Pardon me, Sam, but how about the play that Drury just made? It looked like a simple play, but he knew exactly where to be.
Penalty called. Shane O'Brien got the stick into Nigel Dawes and will go for hooking. O'Brien argues the call, but he'll go off.
Now the Rangers moved it out of their zone, and Jágr with just a little pass off the boards to allow Nigel Dawes to skate into it.
I think Dawes helps this one out right here, Joe.
Well, there's the stick. Oh, and then it gets, yeah, gets caught in his equipment, it looked like. Here's the first shot. They win the faceoff. Look at that. One shot, good, hard, low shot. Force the goaltender to make a save, and then go after the loose puck, and then the next one. Paul Ranger is 54. I think it hit his left skate. Okay. And just changed directions enough. Jágr gets the goal.
And the Rangers get another power play here. They're sixth of the game. They're 1-for-5. With 9 shots on goal. O'Brien for hooking at 12:22. Gomez puts it in front, and it was knocked away from Pruka. It was Drury, not Pruka. My apologies. Peter was giving me the
I wasn't going to say anything. No, I wasn't going to say anything. I thought it was Drury or Shanahan.
Peter Pruka gave me the business the other day at practice. Hey, I'm not Drury. Drury, Roosevelt, Shanahan, Jágr, and Gomez for the power play. Lukovic and Chris Gratton clears it.
That clearing attempt almost hit the referee. That's why you hear the noise in the background. He had to duck out of the way.
One thing I haven't mentioned is that Gratton is back for the Lightning for the third time. He seems so natural here. Here's Jágr going around the net, centering to Drury. In front, they score! Brendan Shanahan! It's a power play goal! And it's 3-1 Rangers!
One of the changes is they've moved Brendan Shanahan in front of the net because of his size and strength. Jágr will attempt the pass that goes all the way through, and then this is a marvelous pass from Chris Drury, and Shanahan with that strength had this stick right on the ice. This puck goes through everyone, and Shanahan repositions himself in front. He fights off two of the players in front. Look at the job by Shanahan. Perfect body positioning, strong on this stick, and a perfect pass.
Rangers, most goals they've scored in a game in the last 5. It's 3-1. They get 2 power play goals. Dubinsky. So the Rangers take advantage of the Shane O'Brien penalty. They have scored back-to-back power play goals by Jaromír Jágr and Brendan Shanahan. And it's 3-1. With 5:50 remaining in the third period. Dan Boyle on now, 5-on-5, as the Lightning try to come back.
Good watch him. He's like another forward out there. He'll join the rush, and he's a sneaky player, smart player.
Rangers doing a good job on the forecheck. Nice pass, send the way to the net. Saved by Lundqvist. And a penalty upcoming on the Rangers. A hooking call. It's on Fedor Tootin. The Lightning with a power play chance of their own. The Rangers lead 3-1, and it stayed 3-1 on a fine save by Lundqvist as he stopped San Luis. The Rangers got the 3-1 lead on Brendan Shanahan's second of the season.